Dr. B. Senthil, HOD of Commerce, KSR College of Arts and Science, Parambur. My today's topic is leverage, an important topic from financial management. Before knowing about the concept of leverage, it is important to know about a basic concept, namely capital structure. If we are clear with the concept of capital structure, it will be easy to understand as to what is leverage. What is capital structure, if you ask? The two terms are there, capital and structure. What is capital, if you ask? The amount invested into business is called as capital. There are two types of capital, namely fixed capital and working capital. These are the two types of capital. What is first one is fixed capital. What is fixed capital, if you ask? The capital which is required to procure long-term assets like land, building, plant, machinery, etc. It is long-term in nature, non-recurring in nature also. Second one is called as working capital. What is working capital, if you ask? The capital which is required to maintain day-to-day expenses of an organization is called as working capital. Whenever we talk about the concept leverage, we should remember only the first type of capital, namely fixed capital. Now come to the point. What is capital structure, if you ask? The proportion between owned capital and borrowed capital is called as capital structure. The proportion between owned capital and borrowed capital is called as capital structure. What is owned capital? The capital which is contributed by owners of the organization is called as owned capital. For example, capital contributed by equity shareholders is the best example for owned capital. What is borrowed capital? As the name says, the capital which is borrowed from outsiders other than owners of the organization is called as borrowed capital. Examples: issuing of debentures, issuing of bonds, getting long-term loans from banks and financial institutions. Now the point is the ratio or proportion between owned capital and borrowed capital is called as capital structure. For example, in a particular company, proportion between these two is 50 is to 50, which means that 50% of the capital is contributed by the owners, remaining 50% of the capital is contributed by the outsiders, that is lenders of the organization. This proportion may vary from one company to another company. For example, for some other company, this proportion may be 40 is to 60. For some other company, it may be 10 is to 90. Likewise, this proportion may vary from one organization to another organization. So whenever we talk about the concept capital structure, one more important concept is closely connected with capital structure, that is leverage. Whenever the company uses these two types of sources of fund for mobilizing capital, risk as well as return are also closely connected with the same capital structure. What are they? Two important elements are closely connected with capital structure: risk as well as return. The proportion between owned capital and borrowed capital may increase or decrease both risk as well as return. That can be measured with the help of a concept which is called as leverage. Where arises the need of leverage? For measuring the relationship between risk and return, we need a concept which is called as leverage. Now we can understand as to what is leverage and what are the various types of leverages. meaning of leverage. In general, leverage means relationship between two numeric values. That is the meaning of leverage in general. But it has some other different meaning in case of financial management. In financial management, what is leverage if you ask? Here, influence of one financial variable over another financial variable is called as leverage. That is, influence of one financial variable over the another financial variable is called as leverage. For example, cost of production may influence profitability of the organization. Similarly, sales volume may influence profitability of the organization. These are the two important examples for leverage in case of financial management. There is a valid definition which is given by Mr. James. This is the valid definition of leverage according to Mr. James. I reproduce as it is. Leverage means employment of an asset or funds for which the company pays fixed cost or fixed interest. It is called as leverage according to James. Here two segments are there. When we analyze this definition, we can easily find out there are two segments of leverage. What is employment of an asset? What is employment here? Usage. We are using something. Usage of an asset for which company pays fixed cost. That is first segment. Process of using an asset for which company pays fixed cost. It is also called as fixed operating cost. For example, company uses a factory or land or building or some fixed assets for which company has to pay rent. It is called as fixed cost or fixed operating cost. This cost is constant forever irrespective of the level of output of the organization. Whether the company produces or not, company has to pay rent, company has to incur some fixed cost. It is called as fixed operating cost. Second segment of this definition is the usage or employment of funds for which company pays fixed interest. For example, in case of borrowed capital, company may issue debentures, bonds, or company may get long-term loans from commercial banks or the financial institution. In such a case, company has to pay interest at the end of every year. It is called as fixed interest. When there is no fixed cost or when there is no fixed interest, there is no concept of leverage. Hence, we can come to a conclusion that use of debt in capital structure is called as leverage. We must use an element of debt in our capital structure. When there is no debt, there won't be any concept of leverage. This is definition of leverage. Now we should talk about three different types of leverages. First one is operating leverage, second one is financial leverage, and third one combined leverage. These are the three different types of leverages. Before knowing about types of leverages, it is very important to know about statement of income. Either in format of statement of income or income statement.
Positive
the second segment of definition, it says like this: employment of funds for which company pays fixed interest. In other words, it indicates the ability of the management to make use of fixed interest for magnifying EPS. What is EPS? Earnings per share. It indicates the ability of the management to make use of the fixed interest to magnify or expand earnings per share. There is a